with an endemic, our city is suffering from gun violence. It's a big problem. It has affected many of us. Anytime I do something involving young people, I always think about the young people who were robbed of the opportunity to celebrate or the opportunity to learn something or to fellowship or to be inspired because their lives were stolen by senseless gun violence. So I'm gonna ask, before we start, I wanna say this. In the atrium, there's an orange ribbon. You feel so compelled. If you lost someone that you have lost, but you want to remember them and keep their memory alive, please sign a name to the anti-gun violence ribbon so that they can be remembered, okay, every day in our school, our peace and social justice school. What I want to do is take a moment of silence to remember those who could not be here with us, but to also, in spirit, invite them to celebrate, fellowship, learn, okay, and be inspired with us today. So I'm going to ask for a moment of silence at this time. Thank you. Now we're going to have our intro, Lift Every Voice and Sing, performed by Latana. Give it up for Latana! Cool owner of talkativeness and cool ancestors.
to Harriet Tubman. Also, coolness to those who recently lost their lives to any type of violence.
Ashe.
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 Ashe-o.
Ashe-o.
Thank you.
Oh, You were under the British crown.
Truly set us free, the cold, hard truth. Thank you. I don't know about you, Jan, but I really enjoyed that museum, and some of the speeches that I heard really had me thinking.
You're right, it definitely did. I like how they stood up there and executed. It really got to my mind. But you know something, Zay? I've been having this little jingle in my ear.
A little what?
A little jingle. Like, I feel like we need an ensemble.
Ensemble from here?
Ensemble from here, yeah.
I don't know.
I think we do got the best ensemble, though.
We do got the best ensemble.
So should we do it?
I think we should do it.
Let's give it up for our Parkway Ensemble.
Go around, but I. pimp and shoot baggers. Having the security on the dirt bag when it didn't matter. All we take all the damage, all the power.
Good job.
On top of dope, get power, we're on the nature. Lord of God, to remember to those strangers. Lord of God, to remember our descendants, only out of suffering, the spirit anger, all the power. Try to copy the same way you got none. Want to copy all the money ain't done, it's not enough. Not the way that we're prepared, it's not enough. Not the way that we gotta work out the mud, that's not enough. We got unity and love, not money and guns. Want to pin the side is a bit of hand to fed them. We're paying for the damages of primitive business. Who do you think that they're first? Who do you think helped them? We are the suffering will suffer instead of them. They try to eradicate the one who came before them in day. One name from our place, but really, I don't get the hate. You want to go ahead and call them slave, but really, I don't want to let myself die slave, it's all the power.
Black kings and queens in your dreams, don't let them suck through the seams. It might get hard, but it's not that as it seems. We all gotta keep playing for the same team while our lives still stay clean. It's gonna get better, so don't cry. Don't let your dream go to die. Let your pride keep your sky high through the night. Black and brown is a beautiful sight. Let your soul shine super bright. No matter your skin color, you're still a sister, brother. Saying you're not just a bluffer. We keep on burning, so we keep on suffering. But if we keep on burning, what do we end up recovering? Treat women as queens and they deserve it. If you don't, you like what's weird. Drive a mess until you hit the curb with nobody to care about you. Thinking the world trying to hurt you. Thinking the world trying to desert you. But we see through it. We don't cower. We all do it. We build up like towers. But hey, we all do it just for power.
right? Let's give them one more round of applause. Let's give them one more round of applause. Well, now, we're gonna be taking a little break with the Black History Month tribute.
With prizes.
Featuring Ms. Z.
And Ms. Morris.
Let's give them a round of applause.
Hello? Okay, so we're going to take a few minutes to test our knowledge of Black history. And we have some helpers up here. We can take about 8 volunteers. If you want to raise your hand to come up on stage for a chance to win some prizes, we need 8 brave individuals. All right, Shia, come on up. Especially the seniors. Let's go, young man. We're gonna have 20 seconds to write our answers on the whiteboard. Nice shout out, Najee, that was sweet. Okay, so we have approximately 5 questions. 20 seconds per question. The student, we're gonna take the top 3. So we're gonna have first, second, and third place. So the student who gets the most questions right will win first place. You get a $25 gift card to Amazon. All right. Then second and third place is going to be a $5 gift card to Dunkin' Donuts, plus a ticket to the gala this evening, and some tickets to our school store. Okay, so Jade is going to read the first question. Is everybody ready? Arlon, do we have time on the clock? All right. Don't worry, guys. The time does not start until the question has been read. Are we ready? All right, here we go.
Okay. First question. Do you have the time on?
Yes.
Okay. First question. Who was the first African-American woman built their empire on Black woman cosmetics?
No, no cheating.
I think it's spelling matters. Is it spelling matters?
Unfortunately, the seniors did erase theirs, but they did have the right answer. So Arlon, they do get a point, but moving forward, you need to keep the answer on the board until time is up. Okay, next question. Here we go.
All right. Okay, the second question is, what famous poet wrote The Phenomenal Woman?
TikTok, TikTok. Hi, Mom. My mom, my grandma's here. The question? What famous poet wrote the phenomenal woman?
It is not too hard.
Stop it. What's your
name? All right. Turn your phone around, everybody.
And the correct answer is Maya Angelou. Okay, so we're going to tally up the answers now and announce the winners. Sorry, we're going to have to hold on that last question. Do we have an announcement of our first place winner? It's a tie.
Oh my goodness.
It's a tie in between Australia and Latea.
Yeah, Latea!
Okay, so we're going to have to do a tiebreaker, but unfortunately we're short on time. So the top three, sorry everyone, they're going to be the winners for today. But I appreciate your knowledge, your excitement, and your participation. So thank you everyone. Can the winners come see me and Ms. Morris for a prize? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Park Bay. Who's ready to see the fashion show? Yo, shout out to the drum line. Let's get a drum line a round of applause. Come on. Alright, so we're gonna take you to our Wakanda Forever fashion show, part one. So we're gonna introduce our models. When they come down the walkway, make sure you guys show them some love. So first, we have coming to the stage, down the black carpet, is Camille Wilkins. Camille is wearing a long white skirt, set up with a mesh cover-up, gold jewelry, natural gold heels, aka Shuri's lab outfit. Let's show Camille some love. Clap it up. All right, good job, Camille.
Come on. Come on.
Camille is wearing a traditional African print long skirt with a white headband. She is decked out with gold and silver jewelry and a white cross shirt. Amazing. Let's go, Chloe. All right, next coming to the stage, we have Nia. Yeah. Nia is showcasing a two-piece brand set with jewelry as her accessories. Let's strike a pose, Nia. Show them what you got. So Camille is rocking a blue dashiki dress with a blue bedazzled head wrap. Look at that bling in that head wrap. There you go. Next coming to the stage, we have Amani Taylor. Amani is showcasing a long white, blue, and yellow gown, and she also has her black heels. Beautiful. Coming to the stage, we have Tajay. Tajay is showcasing her blue African gown with gold, a serpent, a blue headlock, and she has some blue heels to match. Next, we have our songbird, Olivia. Olivia is wearing blue, orange, and black African jumpsuit with blue heels to match. Let's go, Olivia. Coming to the stage, we have Amina. Let's give them a round of applause. Come back for our models once again.
gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? My style be the number one. Get your back up to the wall. Tell me, how you gonna do it if you really don't wanna dance? My style be the number one. Get your back up to the wall. I heard how well music.
I know the words
corner. And first up is going to be R-Line, followed by her Skip. So if y'all know R-Line, you can come and see her. Let's give her a big round of applause.
Lunch counter sit-ins were a nonviolent form of protest used to oppose segregation during the civil rights movement and often provoked heckling and violence from those opposed to their message.
When young African-American students staged a sit-in in the segregated Woolworth lunch counter in Greensboro, North Carolina, and refused to leave after being denied services, the sit-in movement soon spread to college towns throughout the South.
One day,
thank you. true. Because even with all that we went through, our people still found the strength to fight against it. Our people proved time and time again that we are strong, resilient, powerful, and more, holistically and individually. All of us, at some point in our lives, have been through hard times. Some of us are still facing hardships even now. What we've been through and what we're still going through can lead us to feeling unworthy, like we cannot have more. Our minds are constantly under attack. But let's give credit where it's due. We are still here today. So while we're here, it's not too late to make change. And that starts with the mind. If your mental is not there, if you allow those things that were said about us to get to you, it's going to show through you, through your actions and through your attitudes. I'm tired of seeing young Black people who are lost, who don't want more for themselves, who don't even care, who are in the end stagnant. As young Black people, we have to step out of those mindsets. You are doing yourself and your life a disservice by being stagnant. And so many of us have so much potential, if only we believed it and knew how to use it. I am telling you all that you are all worthy of more. You deserve more. All you have to do is believe it for yourself and have the drive to take action and reach it. Stop residing in negativity. You have to think bigger than that, because we are bigger than that. You're not another stereotype or stigma or statistic. You are more. You can be more. All you have to do is change your mindset.
Thank you.
might have seen flyers and posters around the school for our Black History Month poetry contest. I'm happy so many of you entered poems to win. The prize is a $100 cash prize. Can we get a round of applause for that? So now, I'm gonna announce the winner. The winner of the second annual Black History Month Assembly Poetry Contest is... It's already chosen, so y'all good guessing. The winner is... Sarah May!
Thank you.
necktie, bright gloves, sparkling shoes, white top hat, and how can we not forget those Tom Ford glasses? the stairs were staged by Xavier. Oh, forget the flat there fantasy. Let's get them off. There you go. All right. Next we have Rin. Come on down, Rin. Rin is showcasing a flapper dress with silver sequins, black tassel trim, and she has the black heels. Don't forget the strike of pose, Rin. Great girlfriend, you hear it? All right, now we have, coming down, Amani Taylor. Escorted by Jalen Washington to the stage. Don't forget to strike a pose, Amina. And last but not least, doing his second debut outfit, we have Mr. Glenn.
Next year, if you'd like to join, you know where to find me. I'm in the Friday Center Wings.